Good morning, everyone. This is Michael Mao here with the Hurricane Outlook and Discussion for May 14th, 2020, recorded around 9:40 a.m. Eastern Time. Well, we have still not gotten an official designation for Invest90L yet, but we will shortly, I do believe. But the chances have continued to be raised over the next 48 hours, with now a 40% chance of development over the next 48 hours and a 70% chance over the next 5 days. An area of low pressure could develop into a subtropical or tropical system this weekend and early next week across portions of South Florida and the Bahamas. We'll touch on just where I believe that location will be here in just a little bit. Our next update from the National Hurricane Center will be at 3 o'clock p.m. Eastern Time this afternoon. As a quick reminder, if you guys are not following me on Twitter, go ahead and follow me at MikeRomali1. It's on screen there, so if you want to take a picture of it, whatever, make sure to go follow me on there. Well, this is our system that we are looking at. This is coming from the Miami NextRed weather site here, and we are continuing to see these rain bands that are spiraling around, and this has caused a bit of a problem. If we switch over here to the more high resolution rainfall map here, we do notice that we've seen areas that have eclipsed over 5 inches of rain and precipitation already across portions of the Florida Keys, just to the east of Marathon, Florida. While portions over near Miami have seen extremely little rain. And this is what I was talking about in terms of where this cutoff is going to be. It's going to be incredibly important. Now, it's not done quite yet. We are going to see a moisture surge as this continues to lift off again. This still has to lift off further and further towards the north and east here. So this whole entire area is going to get filled in with rain. That's going to send some rain in on the backside of this and be a problem for portions of the Florida coast. Our main concern right now is going to be for areas across portions of the Florida Keys and the extreme southern Florida Peninsula down towards Miami. Southward at this point in time is where the heaviest of rainfall seems to be setting up. If you transition back to the high resolution radar, you can see that we do have these squalls coming in, and actually Marathon, Florida is reporting a gust up to 32 miles an hour. And we have gusts over here to 29 at the MVFR site there. And over here at Key West International, we're getting gusts about 25 miles an hour. That was up to just about 40 miles per hour earlier. So again, this is not even a designated tropical system yet, but we are getting these gusts to near tropical storm force. And these gusts are extending pretty well away. You can actually see some gusts up to about 26 and 27 miles an hour there, or 27 knots rather, at just up on I-95 there. And that what's going to be happening is this larger wind field is causing a problem for some gusty conditions across this area. And that's exactly what we are talking about. Even up here towards the Orlando Metro, we are getting winds and around the 20 to 25 miles per hour range. There is a lake wind advisory for most of the area across this region throughout the day today, so certainly something to kind of keep in mind there. This is the College of DuPage website here. We are taking a look at the infrared satellite. You do notice that these are now some of the outflow bands or semi-outflow bands of this system. Our main system is down here, as you can see. We'll change that to a better color. That's our main system down there, and again, this is going to continue to lift off towards the north and east here over the coming hours and days. What's going to happen is there's going to be moisture that's going to be fetching in from the backside of this, and you notice our flow right now is generally out of the west across portions of the open Atlantic here, so we're getting a lot of westerly flow. This is helping to aid all of this sort of remnant cloud cover to fill in across this area. But this actually is stretching out the other way. Why is that? Because there's some outflow that's trying to kick out, and that is actually helping to ventilate whatever system is trying to get going there. If we take a look here at the wind shear though, our wind shear has begun to undergo some weakening, but we're still dealing with around 60 to 70 knots across this whole entire area, so not really much. But there is an upper level low that is coming out across this region, coming out across here, that will be transversing over the next coming days, and this will be allowing some of this wind shear to weaken. You do notice there's also some lighter wind shear up here as well, so that's going to aid in the development of what could be subtropical or tropical storm Arthur over the coming days. Taking a look here at the sea surface temperatures in Celsius, this was analyzed as 1 o'clock in the morning. This morning on May the 14th from tropicaltidbits.com, we are trying to kind of keep an area watch on here. This is where we do think the best chance of development is going to occur. Again, sea surface temperatures are pretty marginal at this point in time, with only running about 25 to 26 degrees Celsius. Where the system is now, we're in about 28 to 27 degrees Celsius water, so it is warmer, but those warmer waters do not extend that far deep, which is going to be one of the problems and really hindering this from becoming an actual, really a big system down here rooted in the Bahamas, because these ocean temperatures and the upper ocean heat content numbers are pretty lackluster, if anything. Again, if this does form a little bit closer, obviously, to the Florida, the southern Florida coastline here, we do have to watch, because this is the Gulf Stream, of course, and the Gulf Stream is obviously going to be warmer enough to support tropical cyclones. Generally, this time of the year, that favorability is stretching almost up to the just offshore of the Georgia Carolinas area, but you do notice that if you get closer to land here, those sea surface temperatures drop pretty dramatically. So this area really just hasn't had a lot of time to warm back up yet, and again, we don't expect it to be really boiling hot until generally, you know, the peak of hurricane season is when we expect that to really be going. But generally, sea surface temperatures are pretty marginal. Upper ocean heat content numbers are also marginal. This is the spin in the atmosphere, the 850 millibar vorticity coming off the University of Central Wisconsin website here. And this is showing the spin in the atmosphere about 5,000 feet off the ground. And the higher you go up in the scale, the larger the cyclonic spin. You do notice this area just south of the Cuba area right now. That is what we're watching. We're watching this area and also just this little area up here. We are watching for what could be some consolidation to occur generally in this area across here, across the southern Florida Peninsula. Again, this is pretty much in line with the area that we're watching down and through here and what the National Hurricane is saying at this point in time, as this generally will track off towards the north and east here over the coming days. We might even have to adjust this graphic to push it a little bit further to the south and west, but we will see with time. Again, we are continuing to monitor just exactly how strong this bundle of energy can really get going and if it can manage to tighten into a tropical system or not. This is the GFS forecast coming from the 1 o'clock morning run, the 06E run valid. As of 1 o'clock this morning, Thursday, May the 14th, we'll skip it here, just about 30 hours from now, you do notice that we do have that point of air interest lifting out through portions of Cuba and through portions of the Florida Straits. And again, that lines up pretty well with what we're seeing here. This is the area of vorticity that will be lifting off to the north and east. Again, observations are very key at this point in time, because observations is what's really going to set everything in motion at this point in time. Observations, observations, observations. And that seems to be lining up with the observations so far, that this will lift, this area of spin will lift out of the Caribbean and just south of Cuba. That will lift through Cuba during the day today and then through tomorrow, and should set up some tropical cyclone genesis across this region in the coming days. And that is forecast pretty well on GFS. Again, if we go back to the origins, that spins up from that area of vorticity just south of Cuba right now, and by hour 48 we are looking at a tropical system, potential tropical system, just really on top of the Bahamas, just east of the Florida Peninsula. And that continues to show signs of gradual strengthening as it passes somewhere between Bermuda and Cape Hatteras, and obviously the Outer Banks of North Carolina. Again, this looks more almost like a classical tropical system, and for that reason, the National Hurricane Center has mentioned that there is the potential that this could have some warm core characteristics and be a fully tropical cyclone, which would allow for gradual strengthening. Again, sea surface temperatures in this area, if we go back, are fairly marginal where this system would be. Again, you're only looking about 20 to 23 degrees Celsius. If this can find the Gulf Stream, though, become a little bit closer and rooted in that Gulf Stream, we could be looking at some intensity fluctuations that could occur across that region. So certainly something to kind of keep in mind, but We do not expect this to become a hurricane whatsoever. And that will then lift off and probably become an extratropical system, which means that this is going to be getting caught up in this troughiness and really become a part of this trough and do some funky business probably further up to the north. But again, really past 5 days is where we're not going to get into right now. You can see at the 5 day mark, this eventually scoots up and generally off towards the north and east there, away from land, as we get ready for another trough to dig in across the area. Now, if we take a and compare that to the ZRZ European run, we take a look out here to about 48 hours. This is valid as of 8 p.m. Friday night, or ZRZ Saturday, May 16th. We are starting to see that area of vorticity come together here just to the south of the Grand Bahama area. And that continues to lift off towards the north and north-northeast, really, over the next 48 to 72 hours. Again, this will generally be to the east of the Florida Peninsula, but there could still be some rain impact. Certainly some rough swells, squally conditions for setting up for portions of the southern Florida area and the Bahamas over the next coming days. This could dump a lot of rainfall. Again, rainfall estimates right now are well over 5 to 6 inches across portions of the Florida Keys. So certainly something to kind of keep in mind there. But again, generally then over the next coming days, over really out to about 5 days this passes, like I said, right between Bermuda and Cape Hatteras there in the Outer Banks, this could bring some rough swells to portions of the Outer Banks. And so surfers out there, make sure you kind of keep paying attention to this. Also keep paying attention because, again, details are still up in the air. This could become a little bit closer to land or a little further out away at this point in time. Again, consistency and trends in the models this far out is what we're looking for. But there's our trough of low pressure that will be ejecting this off towards the north and east. With this ridge abating back towards the west, we're going to be starting to see this should stay away from land at this point in time. Again, we do have some new equipment coming in for this upcoming hurricane season, and we have a lot of really cool things that we really want to do. So again, keep checking back for the latest on that, and we will be providing really everything that we possibly can for this year's upcoming hurricane season. In fact, we just did a video update not too long ago showing off some of our new equipment that we have, including a new anemometer, handheld anemometer that we have, and our outdoor weather station. This is going to be one of the key players in our research projects that we're going to be doing over the next coming years, we do expect. I hope you all have a great rest of your morning. I will be back with more for you this afternoon.